up? It's your boy Easy, and today we're going to be doing Easy Reviews on No Time to Die. But, yeah, anyways, it's a good movie, man. This will be my Easy Review. Spoiler alerts, because I will be talking about things in the movie that may not have been in the trailer, because who knows how, what kind of trailer you watched. But, yeah, so, I'm gonna give the movie a 3 out of 5. The action was there. I'm not gonna say that. The action was definitely there when it was there. I'm gonna say what, like 5. I'm gonna say 4. 4 good action packed events that are, you know, are fucking good. You know what I mean? But then, like everybody says, you got the plot or the storyline, the climax, the fucking I don't know, whatever you want to call it. All right? I'm going to call it the fucking storyline, all right? The story sucks on this thing, man. It's everywhere, all right. The way the movie starts, I think it's gonna start show like the way it starts is this girl and her daughter are getting assassinated with a guy that wears a white mask. He kills the mom, the girl, she's like hiding. She jumps out of nowhere and lays like fucking like a whole handgun magazine in this guy. He falls the fuck over, and then it shows her like dragging him out, you know what I mean, out into the wilderness. And, fucking, like, you know, he's having a hard time because it's a big body. It falls down, and she's, like, looking at him, and he, like, gasps for air and sits back up. Like, what the fuck? This motherfucker's alive. So she goes running out on this ice. This ice cracks. She falls in. She's, like, trying to get out, and this guy who was going to kill her, but he ends up not killing her and shoots in the ice, saves her. So, like I said, I'm thinking that's the new 007. You know what I mean? That's a little story, you know what I mean? A little bit of the story. Like, a little, sorry, I had a text and it set me off. A little bit of the storyline with the new 007. Boy, was I wrong. That was the girl that he runs off with in the last movie, you know what I mean? That starts off with this movie right there, and that's how it starts off, with these guys in love and everything. It's just great. He has left the fucking industry, and I guess this helps out the CIA here and there or some shit. Well, he goes to visit his the partner that he fell in love with, like, on, like, the, I think it was, like, the second GoldenEye. Or not second GoldenEye, second 007. By the way, GoldenEye 007 on 64, best game ever. But anyways, yeah, so I forget what the fuck I was saying now. But anyways, yeah, so it goes off and fucking, he thinks he goes to visit that gravesite of his, you know, whatever, she died. And it ends up blowing up. So in his mind, he thinks he got double-crossed by the girl, with the girl he's in love with. So he goes back and pretty much tells her, you know what I mean, like, grabs her, keeps her alive the whole fucking time, and throws her on a train and says, get out of my life, you'll never see me again, you double-cross me, I don't care what you say, you double-cross me, and that's what I'm saying, that's my story, and I'm sticking to it, it's like, nah. But anyway, so yeah, and then all of a sudden, 5 years later, all right, we're jumping 5 years later. By the way, this is a 2.5 hour movie, okay? So then, 5 years later, this guy, he's doing like a little thing for the CIA or whatnot, he comes to find out that when he's looking into something, he's like looking into something for the CIA people or whatnot, and it goes bad, and you know, people die or whatnot from this virus that this guy makes that clones to your DNA, and they cloned to like the people that was in the spectral how you say that? They're you know, the bad clan that was in the last movie, or the name of the last movie. Anybody that was connected to that or had, you know, anything, any kind of DNA resemblance or connection with them, they would die. So that was happening, and that goes wrong, and he wants to end up, and he wants to come in contact with the bad guy, or the bad guy from the last movie. I forget his name, and I should have this better together, but I just wanted to get this video out here because I just got done watching the movie. I want my mind to be fresh. So yeah, he wants to get a one-on-one with that guy, and then he finds out that the girl that he ditched, she is the only one that talks to that guy, you know what I mean? And in the meantime, that girl, from the beginning of the movie, the guy that saves her in the ice or whatnot, you know what I mean? He wants that girl, that guy, from the bad guy from the last movie, dead. So he does the DNA thing to her and puts, you know, he gives him like some kind of spray to tell her to spray it on him before he goes. She goes and visits that bad guy because she's the only one that can see him for some odd fucking reason, to, you know, spread the DNA on him. So when she's doing that, she don't know that 007, her ex fucking, her ex fling, was going to be there going in with her. So then she like ends up not wanting to do it, but he ends up touching her. And when he touches her, he ends up touching, which I don't know why they had it so he can touch him, but he ended up touching that one guy and kills the bad guy from the other movie. You know what I mean? So right there and then, you know what I mean? You're thinking that guy is going to be the bad guy of the movie because he's locked the fuck up. And the way he's locked up is crazy. They show you. And he's locked up and he's still pulling strings. You know what I mean? And so I thought that, you know, he was the bad guy and he was like, you know, still controlling the outside and that's what it was going to be. But no, no, no. It was because this guy, we still don't know why, wanted to kidnap James Bond's girlfriend after that happened. And his daughter, he just found out he fucking had. Or she said, no, it wasn't. But we all knew it was. And takes him to the island where all this shit's getting made. And and then they find out where it's at, of course, you know what I mean, however they do it, and they go to the island to, save, you know, his wife and the girl, and this guy, he ends up letting the girl and the fucking daughter go, you know what I mean, like, he's like, all right, I got you, and I guess he just brought him to the island thinking, like, I don't know, I have no clue what the fuck that guy was, had planned with them, you know, bad guy had planned with the daughter and the girlfriend, I don't know. But he ends up letting him go or some shit, and 007, he has to fucking open up the blast door so these bombs can come in because he gave him the location and said the place needed to be blown up because it had all that stuff, all the bad stuff there. And so he does that, and when he's leaving after he opens the bay doors close, so he has to go back, and of course, you know what that means, the bad guy's gonna be there, and sure enough, the bad guy's there, shoots fucking James Bond like 3 times or something, and James Bond still fucks this guy up and kills him, but in the fighting scene that he's killing him, he smacks him with that DNA on his face that... So if he could, now if James Bond comes intact with anybody that's related to his DNA, it's gonna kill. So James Bond, he sacrifices his life because he'll never be able to touch his loved ones again. You know what I mean? I mean touch. You know what I mean? He can't call them and wave to them on Zoom. You know what I'm saying? He has to sacrifice his life. So he ends up spending every energy he has to climb all the way atop and watch these fucking missiles rain down on him and this fucking DNA fucking whatever you want to fucking call it. I forget what they called it. There was a name for it. But yeah. So that's the gist. Like I said, there was no reason for the kid. No reason for the kid. Because, or no, I guess deep down there is, kind of is, you know what I mean? Because it gives him an even more scenario. Not, you know, he can't touch his wife. Now he can't even touch his kid that he found he had. So I guess, in a sense, yeah. But You don't get no backstory from this kid. This kid, literally, the way they make this kid act when he's getting, when she's getting kidnapped and stuff and thrown around, like she's used to it. You know what I mean? Like she's done it 4 or 5 fucking times. Like, oh shit, mommy, I'm getting kidnapped again. So, like, I don't know. I just don't know why they brung the kid in. You know what I mean? And the reason why they brung the kid in, I could think, is that the next 007 or the next sequel of 007s is going to be a female 007. That's the only thing I could think of. And that's the reason why they brung that the daughter in, so they could do that down the road. You know what I mean? With the new 007. That's the only reason. I just think they could have done so much better Daniel Craig's gone away party. You know what I mean? I just think they could have done so much better with the movies being, you know, 2.5 hours long. They could have did so much more on the characters, man. That one girl, there's this one scene where this one agent, she comes in and she's like only been training for like 3 weeks or some shit for this mission. And she goes around and kicks fucking ass, man. That scene is badass. But you just say hi and bye to her and that's it. I think they should have did that with a couple more characters. But whatever. There you have it. 3 out of 4 on Easy Review, baby. Be easy.